The London Board Game! Woo! Well, London is quite bored at the moment, which hopefully will be a old history thing within a couple of months. Right, what's it say on the back? The London Board Game, the classic race through London's underground. Okay, because at the front it says, the classic race, game through London's underground. I think they could have put that over there and made that into one long line of text. Well, anyway, the classic race for London's underground. Take 6 secret destination cards and get ready for a trip on the underground. Woo! Alright, the woo was not there. You'll have to think carefully and plan ahead, for it's the first person who commutes from a mainland station of their choice to their 6 destinations and back again who will be the winner. It feels like I could have done with a... That is a lot of things to say without a full stop. Let's see if we can do that without breathing in. You'll have to think carefully and plan ahead, for it's the first person who commutes from a mainland station of their choice to their 6 destinations and back again who will be the winner. That is a flipping long sentence. It could be Mansion House or Monument, Bank or Baker Street, Wembley or Westminster. You'll not know until the tickets have been issued and the race is on! Exclamation mark. But what? Watch out for the hazards. Every time you change lines, you have to take a hazard card. Ooh, that sounds severe. Which could send you exactly where you don't want to be. Then there are station closures too. The good news is that you'll have to roll... that if you roll a 6, you can open and close a station of your choice. But the bad news is, so can your opponents. Okay, then. So hang on to that strap and get ready for a fast and furious race from the sights of London's capital. It's easy to play, great fun, time and time again. I'm not playing it today, this is an unboxing video. Okay then, so it sounds interesting. I thought I'd buy it off of the Amazon. It was about 25 quid. Let's get in here, let's see what it's like. Right. It's surprising because the game feels quite new, but they went for an old tube train. This is old tube stock. Looks like the old Circle Line trains, which were some of the first to go very recently. That's strange why they went with that. Oh, I love it when board games are brand new because they just don't want to open. Gotta get the air in. Come on. Oh, the suspense is killing me. What's inside the box? If only the box would open. There we go. The London Board Game. Instructions. Yeah, typically black and white, just as expected, or they have bothered to put graphics in. That's nice. Index of stations used in this game. Ooh! Is there a Shepherd's Bush and Hammersmith? Is there a Hammersmith? Yes, there is. That's good. And is there a Shepherd's Bush? Shepherd's Bush. There is. And is there a Ravenscourt Park? Then I'm completely covered. Ravenscourt Park. P, Q, R. No, there's no Ravenscourt Park. No. What other stations are close to me? Guildhall Road. Is there a Guildhall Road? Let's have a look. There is a Guildhall Road! Yes. Wow. So it's quite good for me, but if you're not from London, you're like, well, what's the point of me getting this? Well, let's have a look. Right. Oh, this is the board. That feels quite... It's one of them 4 fold-out boards, look, which I absolutely hate. Gosh, I might have to zoom the camera out a bit here. Yeah, I'm not fond of these 4 fold things because this happens and you got the rough corners there, and I don't like that because they get worn. If it's a good game, it'll get worn, obviously. This is the dice, obviously, or the die, as you constantly shouted at primary school. No, it's not a dice, it's a die. Everyone calls it a dice. Unless you're a teacher yourself. It feels quite cheap. What? These are the pieces. Okay. These don't feel particularly substantial. Because it's not really...
What's this game aimed at? From aged 7 upwards, and there's 2 to 6 players.
Okay. So you've got a purple one, a purple train, probably the Metropolitan. Metropolitan. You got the yellow one, which is the circle line. You got the yellow one, which is the circle line. See how I'm translating here? This is the green one for the district line. This is the green one for the district line. This is the red one for the central line. This is the red one for the central line. This is the orange one. Strange colour for them to chosen. That'll be for the overground. This is the orange one. This is for the overground. And this is the light blue, which is Victoria line. This is the light blue, which is Victoria line. Why did they not pick the dark blue for the Piccadilly? That's weird. Could have picked dark green for that. Oh well, they didn't. Or black for the Northern line. Wonder why they didn't do that. Oh, look at these. These look nice. These are some little counters. And they look suspiciously like, you know when you get a sweet, like a boiled sweet, and you suck and suck and suck and suck and suck and suck and suck until it becomes like a very see-through little counter. That's what these look like. So if you've got kids, I'd be very careful with that because they actually do look like sweets. You've got a cup. Have they actually bothered to supply the little cup for that? Never have I ever used one of these for a dice. I don't see the point. You just throw the dice. If that is what that's for, that is a waste of time. So that's those. I'm glad they've supplied these little pluggy bags, though, so that you don't lose your counters. Because quite often they don't supply pluggy bags, like they've not supplied pluggy bags for these. So these are the hazard cards, and these are the souvenir cards. They don't look different enough. I can see how they'd be quite annoying if you get confused during the middle of the game. And inside the box looks a bit grubby, actually, for a brand new game, which is probably not showing up on camera because nothing ever does. But that's a bit weird, how it looks a bit grubby for a brand new out-the-box game. Anyway, that's that. And this is what you get then. Okay, so this is not the full tube map. Is it all on camera? Yes, only just. Let's get rid of the other things. Put all these back in here for now. Yeah, these could have been a bit more substantial. The tube trains. Let's get all them in there because I don't want to lose these. Can you just do that? Yes, I can. I could just press them with my finger and put them in. Tidy, tidy, tidying up. Oh, I got stuck to my finger still. Let's get the dice in there and let's just get all this out the way for now because I want to see how far they've gone on this. Because it looks like the actual tube map. I think it is because it's actually got version N TFL 03 2011. So in 2011, they were just introducing them new tube trains, by the way, on the Metropolitan line. So I will actually let them off slightly for the old picture on the front. There we go. Because, yes, these would have still been in service for another couple of years before they changed them. Anyway, how far does it go? Now it goes as far south as Balham, Crystal Palace, Annerley, Lewisham, Wimbledon. Says that Ravenscourt Park's on there. Only just. Yeah, because I live somewhere about... There's Shepherd's Bush, and there's Hammersmith, and there's Ravenscourt Park. I live about there. That's what the tube map is like. It goes as high as Highgate and as far west as Hour on the Hill and as far east as Wanstead and Snaresbrook. And there we are.
So it does look as if it's a proper tube map. I don't know why this Waterloo's in red. Maybe this is something to do with the game. Oh, look, Blackfriars is still crossed out. I think for the game, they could have not done that, because that's just confusing. The reason why that was crossed out is because I was building it at the time of the production of this map. So I think they could have just not done that. That's very annoying for the game. Because there's going to be someone playing the game saying, why is that crossed out? Is that something to do with the game? And you're going to be like, no, it's just crossed out because it's just crossed out. Because the station was closed, but nothing to do with the game. Let's have a look at these cards, see what they feel like, the quality. Oh gosh, they've been shrink-wrapped in, well, heat-wrapped, shrink-wrapped, whatever it is wrapped. Flipping heck. Do you know how? And yet butter still comes in just folded down foil paper. Not even foil paper half the time, is it? And lard. Lard just comes in like waxy paper, doesn't it? Anyway. These are the hazard cards. I'm going to have to find someone to put these cards in so they don't get lost. They feel quite plasticky and very, very thin. I don't know how long these are going to last. Looking as pristine as they do. Depends on how much you play the game. So what is this? So these are the hazard cards, which are... It's your birthday. Send all the players to buy presents and Petticoat Lane Market. Originally Hog Lane. This second-hand market dates from the 16th century station Aldgate. Oh, right, I see. So it's giving you information about London. That's nice. It's also, that's a bit of a Monopoly kind of card, isn't it? Because that's like, collect £10 from each player. But in this case, they're sending you to Petticoat Lane Market. I don't even know where that is. Okay, let's have a look at another. I won't show all of these because it'd be unfair for people wanting to play the game. It's your birthday again. Send all the players to Petticoat. That's the same card. And the same card. That's three. You've got to shuffle them by the looks of it. So it looks like they've duplicated the cards three times. Go window shopping. The best place for such activity is Bond Street. Go there at once. Oh, that's very, very old school English, isn't it? Go there at once. Well, you might want to go there at twice. What are you going to do? And... while away a little time by missing a turn. Alright, and you got some couple there, which, well, that's not really a couple, is it? They look like a very strange, very younger boy with an older woman, but he's got his hand round her. That looks quite incestuous. That's not a good picture. Yeah, same one again. What's the next one? Taken ill and it's got... Oh, that's a very timely card, isn't it? Taken ill. You are feeling unwell. Ask the nearest player to accompany you to Harley Street Station, Regent's Park. No, I think you should stay at home and should stay inside and not go out. It's that one again and that one again. What's the next one? This is my last one. Suspense. I don't want to ruin the game for everyone. Sightseeing tour. Take your aunt to the... Take your aunt on a round London sightseeing bus tour. Go straight to Victoria to catch the train. Departure and miss a turn whilst you enjoy yourself. Alright then. So that's those. At least we know now what those cards are. Let's keep those in the same order. I'm going to do that. Oh, you can't see that on camera, I don't think. Oh well, that should be all in the same order. Now let's have a look at these souvenir card. Souvenir, a word that I just cannot spell without checking it on spell checker first. Or until that annoying red line comes up underneath. Which is increasingly annoying to anyone who's English because it redlines correctly spelt words such as colour, flavour and odour. Right, these are the souvenir cards. What have we got on this? Wimbledon Park. Wimbledon. I love the word Wimbledon. Wimbledon. You can say it while you're shaking your head. Do it with me. One, two, three. All together now. One, two, three. Wimbledon. Wimbledon is the home of the All England Lawn Tennis and Croquet Club. and the setting of the famous Wimbledon tennis tournament since 1877. It is the only remaining major grass court tennis venue in the world. There you are. That's Wimbledon. Is this going to be Wimbledon again? Oh, it's not. White City. Oh, that's not too far from me. That's where Westfield is. Oh, look, it's a picture of Westfield as well, look. Westfield is a pioneering shopping and leisure destination and the largest shopping mall in London. Opened in 2008, it took 13 million man hours to build. This is where women are saying, "Ew, women built it as well!" In the middle of the development is the pavilion with a glazed roof covering a central atrium the size of a football pitch. Construction used enough concrete to fill 117 Olympic swim pools. There are 96 escalators and over 20 million people are expected to visit each year. 96 escalators. There's 96 escalators in Westfield. Yeah, you know what? You know when you're in Westfield, you would never imagine there was that many because it always seems like you're miles away from an escalator. Fun fact. What's the next card? Westminster. No, you don't wobble your face when you say Westminster because obviously this is all parliamentary stuff. In 1834, a fire destroyed the Palace of Westminster. A competition was organised to create a new building for the two Houses of Parliament. A design by Charles Barry was chosen from 96 entries, creating a large complex in neo-Gothic style and incorporated the buildings that survived the fire. The whole complex was finished in 1870, more than 30 years after construction started. The most famous part of Barry's design is the elegant clock tower. Originally called St. Stephen's Tower, it was soon renamed after the tower's largest bell, the Big Ben. Well, there you are. And there is a picture of Big Ben, probably taken before the restoration, obviously. Well, this is actually quite good. Wembley Park, obviously Wembley Stadium. Use this station for both Wembley Arena and Wembley Stadium, which replaced the famous Twin Towers in spring 2007 and quickly re-established itself as the country's leading venue for sports and entertainment events. Yeah, quite a lot of people get confused between Wembley Arena and Wembley Stadium, me included. They are obviously right next to each other. It's very, very confusing. Just go to Wembley. And, yes, the new stadium offers up to 90,000 fans the opportunity to watch world-class events and unravel views of the action of the state-of-the-art facilities. I wonder if there's any more near me. Warren Streets. The BT Tower. This is the BT Tower one. Look how tall it is against everything else in London. Ooh. Well, when you're looking that way, because obviously there's the Shard and the walkie-talkie building now. The BT Tower is 189 metres high. It was built to transmit telephone calls and television programmes. Telephone calls and television programmes using microwaves rather than underground cables. The tower was officially opened by the public on the 16th of May 1966 as Tony Bennett and Billy Butlin, that's his name, Billy Butlin, that's very British-y naming sounding, isn't it? Billy Butlin. As well as the communications equipment and office space, there were viewing galleries, a souvenir shop, and a rotating restaurant. Yes, the BT Tower uses microwave technology. Do you find people running around London, raving their arms around, saying that, "Oh, that's what's caused all this kerfuffle with coronavirus"? No, we didn't. Because people blaming flipping coronavirus on flipping 5G are ridiculous people. Your Wi-Fi in your house uses the same technology. If you've got Wi-Fi in your house, you've got the same 5G technology in your house. So people need to, well, not people, really, those idiots need to calm down. One last card, and I'm done. And we're going to go for Tower Hill. The Tower of London was the most infamous place of imprisonment, torture and execution and murder of personages close to the crown in Tudor times. Here, Sir Walter Raleigh spent 13 years. Chancellor Thomas More and wives of Henry VIII, Anne Boleyn and Catherine Howard lost their heads to the axe. Can you imagine if they still did beheadings today? I wonder who would be beheaded today. Yes, probably people who believe that 5G is the cause of coronavirus. Anyway, that's those really. I'm not going to do them all because I'm hoping to play this game. I'll learn how to play it. and I'll play it with Sherlock one day. Anyway, thanks for watching. Please press bell. Let me know in the comment section down below. Do you think this looks as if it's going to be really interesting? Or do you think it looks as if it's going to be boring? Let me know. Yes. Anyway, thanks for watching. Scrass, Bellamy. See you when I see you. Bye.